Hey guys, John here from FlyMikeAlpha.com, and today I'm going to be talking to you about high-speed taxiing, or basically practicing for landings without actually leaving the ground. So how we're going to do this, our goal today, is to get the nose wheel up off the ground, main gear on the ground, and maybe they bobble around a little bit, maybe they get airborne and set back down again. But we're basically practicing for that moment when we come in and flare and put the mains on the ground first, and we're doing this without ever leaving the ground. We're going to get a lot more practice in this way, using the whole length of the runway to simulate a very long, mushy landing, compared to just coming in and doing touch and go after touch and go after touch and go. So we're going to do this in the landing configuration, even though we're still on the ground. So I'm going to go ahead and set 25 degrees of flaps. Fuel pump is on. We're all configured. I'm going to go ahead and trim for landing as if we were coming into land. So everything feels the same here. And then we're going to go ahead and take the runway, and our radio call will be that we're making a high-speed taxi down the runway. Not that we're departing the area or departing the runway, but high-speed taxi. Venice traffic, Cherokee 07 Whiskey, high-speed taxi runway 23, Venice traffic. That lets everyone know that we're going to be taxiing down the runway, using the whole runway, but actually leaving the area anywhere. We're going to go ahead and get line up just as we would for takeoff. And now if you're doing this in a Piper Cherokee or in a Piper product, more than likely you're going to have to be very delicate with your rudders as the nose comes up and down off the ground, because if you put rudder in, and then the nose comes back down, remember, you get that direct connection between the nose wheel and your steering and your feet, and you'll have pretty aggressive left or right turning tendencies as that nose wheel comes down if it is cocked to the side there. So right as the nose comes down, be aware to kind of ease up on both feet and just let the nose straighten itself out and then put your rudder and put back in again. I'm going to go ahead and ease in power here. I'm just not using full power, setting about 15 to 1700 RPM, pulling back a whole lot. We really have no crosswind today. Wind's coming just about right down the runway. I'm working it to get that nose wheel up off the ground there. I'm just trying to hold the airplane right here, just as if I was coming into land. I'm using my rudder to control direction. I'm looking down, I can't actually see anything in front of me, okay? I can't see over the nose. This is a good landing flare. This is a full stall landing, as if we were coming into land. So even though I can't see over the nose, my focal point is still right in front of me, looking as far down the runway as I can, even though I can't see it. And I'm really using my peripherals to tell how high I am and if I'm left or right off the ground. And we get picked up by a little gust of wind there, no big deal. Checking as we cross the runways here. This is just what you would do when you're landing. You're milking the airplane for all the speed she's got. We can pull her up in the air here. And as we get airborne, we have to use some crosswind correction here. And when we want to settle down, we just pull that power out, hold the airplane off the ground as we normally would, and the airplane settles down. Using appropriate crosswind correction here, a little bit of crosswind from the right, and just enough to keep the nose up in the air, looking down the runway. Also being aware not to scrape the tail here, using the controls as generously as I need to maintain small changes in pitch with the nose. And if we get airborne here, say I add a little too much power, no problem at all. I can just go ahead and reduce some of that power, reduce a little pitch, and the airplane comes back down onto the ground. And right as the nose is getting ready to come back to the ground, we want to make sure that we're light on our feet in the rudder pedals so that we don't let the nose sit down when the nose wheel's crooked, and that's going to take us sharply left or right all of a sudden.
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching, and thank you so much for sharing us on Facebook, Twitter, and all the other social media sites. If you have any questions about the video at all, just leave them in the comments below and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Be sure to give us a thumbs up on our video, and you can subscribe to us to keep up with all our latest episodes right over here on the right. Also, check out some of these other helpful videos below, and remember, if you can't fly every day, then fly at MikeAlpha.com. We'll see y'all next time.